this country here, I don't see things which I shed tears for. The whole of Kokoi, no one hospital got it. I don't find out for the woman that they work out, belle woman they work out from that, from far villages, for come, but a lot of them they lost their picking them on the way. A lot of them they die with the picking them. That one I refuse that one. As a woman, I don't get belle, I don't want picking them, I will not encourage that. That the first thing we are going to prioritize. One day I came across a lady, I visited Ward 2, you know, and the lady was crying and I said to her, why, what happened? And she said to me, said, I've lost my baby and now I've lost my husband. I said, what happened? She said, well, here we don't have no health center. She said to me, I was pregnant 9 months and I was going to have birth and on my way, I was with my little girl and I got into labor. And I sent my little girl to go and call the grandparents, and by the time they came, my sister died with the fit of her baby in her hands, you know. And she has been she was actually very, very sad about that. I said to myself, I said, boy, I'm a woman, I'm a mother. How can I let go, you know? That alone motivated me, that alone got to me, and I decided that, you know, for the past 57 years, men have been ruling that country and they could not even think about us, we the women. I am under an independent because I am born SLPP. My dad was SLPP. But when it came to distribution of symbols, when I presented myself, boy, it was like something else. So the executive members of Kalam district decided that, you know, they cannot give it to me because the incumbent was much popular than I. So they decided to give it to him. And I said to myself, no, for the sake of my people, because these are not the people that are going to make me win. It's my people. So I don't really care about them. So I said to myself, I have to go help these people. I mean, the most important challenges I had was my incumbent. You know, he didn't want that at all. So my incumbent was kind of very aggressive, intimidating, you know, threatening people because of the party that was probably coming into power. So these are the challenges I was having because people were kind of afraid. Yes, I knew about search for common grounds. It was, I think you guys were within the district, you know, walking. Then somebody said to me, do you know Search for Common Grounds? I said, no. I said, what do they do? He said, boy, these are guys that are walking that will expose you, that will sell you. I said, well, I haven't seen them yet. He said, okay, don't worry, they will come. And indeed, I came across you, and it was like another door opened for my success, you know. The exposure you guys brought to Bredu, as at that time, the debate, you know, the time, because I left alone with the incumbent, who was probably thinking you guys were going to give him 10 minutes and the rest of us two minutes, you know, but it gave us equal time to express ourselves, and the interview was so rich, the questions were so necessary for people to know. That is like bomb. It's another door open for Lulu. So you really came to my aid as an independent candidate. I had nobody, you know, because people used to say we don't have, they're not get daddy. We don't have fathers. We don't have, you know, a president that is supporting us. But Search for Common Grounds was there and was always there, you know. So I think you should continue this thing next 5 years to come, you know. Because I think we only need you guys. It was all over the constituency. You did it in Bredu after, and then you went at in one of the other towns, you did it there. And all of a sudden, each time I'm passing, lo, they were answering, yeah, we saw you, you know. Like it was scattered like good news all over the place, you see. They were calling me, telling me, Lolo, what exactly? Yeah, I was not expecting that you would say all these things, and you know, we never knew about all these things. I said, well, this is it. So they were happy. So for us, talking drums should stay in this country too. Actually, for we, the women especially, you know, it is so so powerful for us, you know. Yes, there are challenges because the loser, I mean the incumbent, lost the election because they were not expecting them to lose the election. And then the executives in the Kailan districts were disappointed because they spoke to me. They told me that I should step down, and they said I'm not going to win. But for the fact that I challenged those tycoons, you know, and I won them, Jesus helped me. And I'm sure I'm going to beat them again. Now, it's like they are segregating me. So it's like he is banging heads and setting fire between the followers or the incumbent and my people. They were arrested, put into prison because, this, you know, allegations upon allegations. So, but I said to myself, I'm not going to let go also. During our campaigns, you know, we actually promised a lot of things, you know, a lot of other things we wish to do in our constituencies. So they came, it's sort of to remind us, hey, woman, I think when we are campaigning, you said this, you said this, you said this, and you said that. And we are there to remind you that, please, go ahead, work hard, and, you know, let these promises come true. What I would like Serge to come and do in my constituency is to bring us all together, because we are all brothers and sisters. And if you look into it, a younger brother cannot talk to an elder brother. A wife has even decided to divorce a husband because of that. So we would like all, you know, sent to come as a body, so that he can bring us all together and really resolve this problem. I'm pleading to Serge to come, and as strong as they are, because I'm an example, because they actually contributed to what I am today. So I'm sure they are strong enough and very, very convincing, so that it will bring my people together and make peace.